I'm going to tell you today about the beauty blender sponge which you need to know. So as the name suggests, the beauty blender is for blending the cosmetic or especially foundation or concealer which you apply on your face. So this is how they look like. This is a teardrop shaped sponge. So this is of regular size, and this one is my favorite. This is micro mini sized teardrop shape beauty blender sponge. So this is the difference. So why beauty blender sponge? First of all, so for blending the foundation or concealer, you can either use your fingers or you can use brush. The pros and cons of these two are, when it comes to fingers, there are chances, especially if you have nails like me, you can't reach the corner of the eyes and this corner. So reaching out here, it's kind of a tricky job. So when it comes to brush, while you blend it, because of the strokes, you get a cakey look or lines on your face, which doesn't really look good. So, but the best part of the sponge is the way you use it. It gives you a dewy and very soft finalized look. So let me tell you how it works, and I'll show you how to use this. So first of all, these are nothing but sponges. These have got pores, so you can't use it when it is dry. So basically what you need to do is, so I'm taking a cup of water, I'm just dipping it, squeeze it, let it absorb some water. So technique here is, the pores will be filled with water, so it won't be able to absorb the foundation which you'll be applying. So that is how you can save some of your foundation, so it doesn't waste it. So now it is damp, but you can't use it when it is wet. So you just squeeze out the extra water. So now this is damp. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna apply foundation and blend it using the sponge. So idea behind the shape of this is, the bottom, which is a wide one, this is used for applying foundation on the wider area, and the sharp edge, so this one is used to cover up the corners. So let me show you. So I'm gonna apply foundation on the sponge and just, I'm not just dragging it or just blending it, I'm just dabbing it. So as you can see, it has not reached the corner of my eyes. So that is how I'm gonna use this one. I'm just gonna apply extra foundation. So this indeed gives a very soft and dewy look, finished look. So I'm gonna repeat that on the other side as well as on my forehead. And one thing I must tell, a kind of con, that is, you need lot more product when you are using a sponge than when using fingers. So for nose bridge, I'm using the pointed end. So now I have completed applying and blending the foundation on my face. So this is how I use the regular sized blender. So let me tell you how to use the smaller one. So basically the smaller one, you can use it for applying foundation provided you have hell lot of time and patience, because for the obvious reason it's very small and you need to dab a lot to cover entire face. So in order to cover entire face, I would really suggest to go with the regular sized one rather than this one. So it has absorbed water, so it has increased in its size. I'm gonna squeeze out the extra water. So you must be thinking, what exactly is the need to use this one? So I'll tell you. So this is I can say to highlight the area here, the eyebrow bridge, and on the nose bridge, as well as to apply highlighter. So this is the very primary reason to use this one. So I'm gonna use this highlighter. I applied the highlighter on my sponge. If you use the regular sponge, I don't think it will give you this perfect look, because it's obviously huge and it can't really cover as nicely as this little one does. So for applying blush, so you just have to blend it. Plus, you can use this for blending concealer or foundation in and around your eyes. So, if I use concealer here, so for this, you can use the pointed edge of the regular sized blender or the smaller one as per your convenience. So yeah, so this is the dewy look which you get by using a beauty blender.